Today we are going to look at the extrusion processing, and you might have tasted some of these extruded products, and the most famous one is your kurkure, the cheese ball. When children especially love these, and pasta kurkure, or even the pasta that you eat, or some of the expanded snacks in the form of rayons that we consume. So these are very, very tasty yet healthy, and that is why extrusion has a lot of advantage, wherein this extrusion processing is also called as a novel approach or a novel processing method for preparation of healthy snack. Okay, so let's understand what is extrusion. So basically, as I explained yesterday also, why there is a need of a healthy nutrition, or why consumers are demanding for a healthy nutrition. So because of the globalization, consumerism, and we are more aware, obviously I will choose a healthy snack over the non-healthy one. Okay, and that too, nowadays with the technology, it is so that it is available and at an affordable price. So obviously, as a aware consumer, I will go for a snack which is healthy. So extrusion system is the processing method which meets the current constantly changing requirement. And if you have got any opportunity in the department, we have a twin screw extruder, a very good quality extruder. Of course, these extruders are very, very expensive. So in our department, we have that extrusion system, and I'm sure you must have seen that, or you must have done instrumentation practical. In the instrumentation practical, generally all these sophisticated instrument are shown to the students, and I'm sure you must have seen and you are aware about how versatile, how innovative way this machine can be used. Okay, and it's very flexible, it is a very economical way of processing. How we will see today. So food extrusion plays a very, very important role, because it's not just snacks, but there are so many products and there's so much of research going on extruded products, because it's a very, very versatile, innovative, novel technique wherein you can use anything and convert it into a very tasty with a very good textural properties, sensorical property, and so many physical, functional, chemical, and sensory properties of the food can be changed. For example, if you have even waste, okay, so for example, I have a peanut, after peanut extraction, you have a peanut cake, or suppose pomace from the fruit. So that pomace, you know, addition to other products as such becomes so challenging. So suppose if you say, you know, apple pomace, and if I powder it and add it into cake or some other product, it may not have that acceptability over the one if I put it along with the extrusion. It gels or it homogenizes so well that you cannot identify. Okay, so there are multiple number of advantages this extrusion has. So because this extrusion process involves a variety of combination of several unit operation, it is not just one unit operation. So these are a combination of several unit operations, like in the extrusion system you will also see there is a mixing happening, also kneading happening, cooking is also taking place at the same time, sterilization of the product is happening so that it becomes safe for consumption. Microbiology, microorganism, bacteria, yeast, mold, they are killed because the temperature is so high. So sterilization takes place, drying also of the material takes place, the water activity or moisture content of the final product goes down, melting of the component takes place. There is a shearing action or shearing force, also shaping, forming, texturizing, puffing, all these effects are happening in one single process. Okay, so you must have heard about that there are different dies, like you suppose if I want a hole or circle shape, or if I want a star shape, or children generally likes these shape. So you, I if I put bear shape, or you have these beautiful, shapes. So the way I put any die after this expansion at the end of the stage. So these dies helps in shaping the product. So that is why it's so variety. It can give you variety of product and how many number of shapes are there in this world, or that you know you can have now that number of final products. So there are multiple advantages of extrusion processing. So extrusion processing is used to create the food of a fixed cross-sectional profile. So materials here are pushed through a die of the desired cross-section to produce a high quality food product. How we will see in principle and step by step. So basically this extrusion technology has proved to be the most useful processing technique to deal with the modern consumer's demand of food due to its numerous advantages. Production of innovative foods. What do you mean by innovative food? So you don't need any fat. See, right now the consumer want the product rich in fiber, rich in nutrients, rich in bioactives, and at the same time it should not add the calorific value. So you can have a very very innovative food wherein you are adding certain bioactive constituent, and it is possible. So there are multiple number of research are carried out wherein pigments have been added, vitamins have been added, and varietal innovative foods are prepared. High production rate, because this machine, like extrusion machine, has a very very good high production ability than any other cooking method or any other processing system. The product that you get is really high quality products. Versatility means this machine or the system, the extruder, allows cooking and processing of different formulas. What do you mean by different formulated products? Like for example, suppose I want to have rice, so rice based product, so I will have a formula. I can do the rice extruded. At the same time, I want legume, chickpea, B formula added with legume, added with fiber, added with lycopene, added with pigment, added with the vitamins, added with minerals. So I can have variety of formulas or different formulas with only one machine itself. But only thing what you have to change, you change process parameter and system parameter. Only this thing, if you play, you can have a very good quality. Okay. Product with different shapes can be obtained with the help of dies. It's very easy. Initial cost is low, but overall, if you see, it has a very very low manufacturing cost. For example, suppose you want to make X or A kind of product. Suppose you are making noodles, okay, or any extruded product using the traditional or conventional method. So you will need at least 5 labor. But with this machine, like one person will need for kneading, though one person is needed for putting into the suppose machine, conventional machine, and the third person is needed to dry or further process it. But here you don't need a lot of labor because of the most of the processing unit operations are carried out in one single machine. Labor, so therefore less labor required. The floor space requirement per unit of production is very very small. You have seen this machine is kept in front of the space that is available in our in front of the classroom. There is Lakshmi Madam's office. In front of that there is a small space, like almost a table, or a big table, computer table, if you see. So little bigger space, it doesn't require a much space. Okay, so that requires a little space. this method is also called as a green method because it does not produces any effluent. You don't need much water, not require any effluents or chemicals are produced during method, or any gases are not produced during this processing. So therefore this is also environmental friendly and a very, very green method. As I said, legumes, cereals, pulses, all sort of material is possible to process into this extrusion processing with a very, very tasty, expanded, high textural quality product with a better stability. At the same time, there are multiple number of researchers because this process involves HTST, high temperature, short time. Therefore, nutrients are preserved, but at the same time, there are anti-nutritional factors. Okay, there are anti-nutritional factors that are present in the legumes. For example, horse gram. Okay, there are lots of products produced and commercially also available. Horse gram has lot of polyphenols, tannins, and anti-nutritional factor. Or soybean has a trypsin inhibitor. Or peanut has some inhibitors or protein inhibitors. So because of this high temperature, these anti-nutritional factors, they are like inactivated or they are removed, okay, at that high temperature. And therefore, the digestibility of the processed final product is improved. It's not only for legume, but also cereal. For example, if you see whole wheat, okay, or along with the bran, if you process, or sorghum, if you process, or in fact rice. So if you see rice, just starch, it is not like native starches or native flours are not digestible. But then if you have an extruded product, the digestibility of the extruded product is a very, very good, very, very high digestibility. Also improved assimilability of the ingredients of the feed. Same anti-nutritional factors is reduced. Therefore, this assimilability of the ingredient is very good. It is one of the most economical way of converting indigenous raw materials such as wheat and rice into physically, nutritionally, and sensorically acceptable finished product. As I said before, because of the destruction of the toxic substances and microorganisms at a high temperature, the anti-nutritional factors are removed or destructed, and therefore the product that are obtained, that is extruded, have a very, very good digestibility over the non-extruded product. Increased stability. There are multiple number of studies wherein during extrusion processing, more stability of lycopene, carotenoid, some of the vitamin like thiamine and so many other heat sensitive nutrients had shown a more and better stability during storage than the other processing methods. So therefore, novel type of product with a very, very high nutritional qualities can be produced using extrusion method. Extrusion process can be configured according to the raw material to produce good quality products regarding texture, bulk density, expansion. So as we know, generally there is a main requirement. However, people are working, or the scientists have been working so much that they have identified novel additives. But generally, you need a starch. And we know that starch has a capacity of undergoing a process of called as a gelation or expansion. Okay, it gets expansion. Okay, it gets expanded. So higher expansion of the product is due to the gelatinized starch. So any cereal or legume or any ingredient that has a starch can be used in the extrusion process. Okay. So it's due to the gelatinized starch, and also there are papers wherein due to the extrusion processing, the starch gets degraded, okay, or modified due to the extrusion process and gets converted into dextrin. So dextrins are nothing but a smaller unit of the glucose, smaller unit of the glucose. Salt, sugar, fats, they also have effect, but then a very, very little effect. So if you are making a formulation A in which you want to add some fat or salt, so even if you want to add these ingredients into the formula, it won't affect on much on the final quality. So you have a very good vehicle to add these ingredients so easily. Otherwise, if you look at the other processing methods, conventional method, if you add little or more content of these ingredients, it has adverse effect or significant effect. Novel protein sources such as legumes, oil seeds, single cell proteins are extensively used. As I mentioned, using peanut cake, which is obtained from the oil industry, where it is a waste, where this is a waste, and it has around 40 to 50% of the protein. The protein quality is really very good. So this is currently, this peanut cake is currently used as a cattle feed. But can you imagine 40 to 50% of the protein? At the same time in India, you see severe malnutrition, protein calorie malnutrition. So instead of throwing this, if you extrude it, it really gives a very good quality product. Also, single cell protein coming is a very novel or cheap source of protein. So this can be also easily converted into extruded, and the final product is very good quality. Two of my students have worked on this peanut cake and the single cell proteins and their extrusion. So among legumes, chickpea, mung beans, soybeans, peas are very, very important sources of protein along with the optimum amino acid composition. So addition of these legumes along with the, either, you know, there are efforts going on and industries are taking help from the scientists like us, as well as they themselves have purchased these extruders and they are working wherein if 100% legumes can be used in the extrusion and converted into extruded, wherein we can say that, you know, it's a high protein snack. Or, but then there are a lot of difficulties during just protein, high containing protein materials are not possible to extrude it. We will see what materials are easy to extrude it and which materials are not suitable slowly. So we will see. So in generally, high protein compounds creates choking. So they are not, they do not give a very good expansion. So in that case, rice or the cereals that have a high starches are generally used. So either if we can use 50% of the cereal plus 50% of the legume, or 30-40 or 30-70 or various. Okay, so balanced composition of the essential amino acids. So we know that cereal are rich in certain amino acids, whereas legumes are lacking certain amino acids, cereal like lysine and methionine. So if you combine cereals and legumes together, the amino acids that are not available in the cereals are, if we combine legumes together, can be made. So this blend gives an added advantage. Okay, and sometimes because of the beany taste, for example, soya bean has a very beany taste, or horse gram, or we call it as a kulit. We don't consume because it has lots of protease inhibitor, also tannin, so it gives little bit bitter taste. So even these compounds can easily, if added along with the rice and corn, they go very well and their utilization increases. And as I said that during the extrusion process, a very important phenomena occurring is called as a gelatinization of starch, which results into increased digestibility for the human enzyme. As we know that human cannot digest a polysaccharide, that is a native polysaccharide, starch. This process also utilizes the byproducts such as spent brewer spent grain or fruit pomaces. Winery industry, grape wine industry has a lot of pomace, so effectively the byproducts can be utilized. These ingredients or byproducts can be incorporated into cereals to develop ready to eat expanded products, and its effect on the textural functional properties of extruded are so good. Like there are paper wherein pomegranate peel or apple pomace or grapes pomace have been added in the extruded product, and the quality is really, really very good. Extrusion cooking involves basically a high temperature treatment for a very, very short time, and because of this high temperature short time process, the microbial contamination is reduced, and at the same time there are certain enzymes that are present. We have seen in wheat there is an amylase enzyme, or if you take oat there are certain enzymes, or in legumes there are proteases enzyme, or certain oil seeds lipases will be there. So these enzymes are easily inactivated during this HTST process. The main method of preservation of both hot and cold extruded food is by low water activity of the product. So here the water activity of the final product goes to just 0.1 to 0.4%, very, very low water activity, and therefore it also helps in increasing the shelf life. You must have studied the water activity. Okay, so lower the water activity, higher is the shelf life, because microorganism also need the water for their growth. So in this extruded product the water activity is very low, therefore these products are having a very good shelf life. So just to see quickly how this extrusion has evolved. So application of this extruder in the food system started in 1930. Of course, extrusion is also applied in plastic making, various plastic. You have seen that nowadays there are a lot of plastic material you get, and with a very beautiful shape, sizes. In pharmaceutical application also extruded these tablets and many other extruded medicine can be prepared. Okay, so but in food the application of extruder started in 1930 when it was used for the preparation of pasta products, okay, using this rava or semolina flour and water. Afterwards, the ready-to-eat breakfast cereals were also developed. Colette extrusion was introduced in 1940s when oil and flour were used to produce snacks with highly expanded cereals. Look here, if you use oil, the expansion also increases. Large extruders were introduced in 1950 to process even legumes, cereals and other byproducts. The flood of innovation keeps on improving the technology over the time. See, right now also in extrusion, see, you can see from 1930s to today is 2020. So much of time has passed, but still people are trying to do a lot of innovation, and this keeps happening. Okay. So it has, because it has a vast application in the field of food as well as feed industry. So let's understand what happens during an extrusion. Okay. So as I said that it is a combination of various unit operation. The combined action of several physical factors is realized on the fact in on the final product. Okay, suppose I put rice grits. Okay, there are criteria like what should be the size of, suppose I use rice, the grit size is decided. If I use wheat, the size is decided. Corn. So for each material, because the each material, the ingredient that is used for the expansion is starch, and the starch has two consist of amylose and amylopectin. Also, not only amylose, amylopectin. At the same time, we have seen that presence of lipid, fat, fiber, minerals, pigments, and many other constituent water affect on the final quality. So this is one of the parameters. So intense shear, pressure, and temperature and conditions are created for the occurrence of a thermodynamic process. Okay. It is also called as a thermodynamically processed starch. This process, when you have a very high starch, for example rice, or there are people who are just taking like potato starch or just starch from any cheap sources, and they produces, you know, this starch or various other products from the starch. Okay, so what happens in the extrusion process? There is an intense shear, pressure, temperature, and there are other conditions that are created so that there is occurrence of a thermodynamic process which leads to the restructuring of the product. Restructuring means I am just putting rice grits, okay, and now I have an extruded, like expanded products of a desirable. See, size and shape all depends on the dye that I use, but then from the grit, I am producing highly digestible, highly cooked, expanded, which has a different mass, density, texture, sensory, color. So I am changing its physical property, its chemical property, means like now this product is no more undigestible. It is completely digestible. That is why this extruded technique, extrusion technique, is also used in production of as an infant foods. Okay, so you can see there is a complete restructuring of the product with respect to physical parameter, chemical parameter, nutritional parameter, functional parameters. So extrusion dispersion of the grain is apparently accompanied by micronization of nutritional components. Okay, so we will see in detail when I show you the picture. So there is a micronization of nutritional component, so that therefore there is a stability. Okay, suppose I add lycopene and carotenoids. So these compounds, when I add along with the extrusion process, these molecules are becoming so small to molecular and submolecular structures, so that their stability is increased. And in spite of having high temperature, you can see the molecules are not degraded. Okay, so lycopene stability is improved, carotenoid and many other nutritional pigments, their stability is increased. Okay, so therefore extrusion is also called as a very, very versatile process, which comprises the operations like it also helps in mixing, homogenization, micronization. It cooks by causing completely converting indigestible material to digestible material. It causes kneading, so that whatever you add, it homogenizes. There is a shearing forces because of the screw. It gives a very good shape as per your requirement, or forming as per your requirement. So it is a multifaceted technique in which a moistened expansible starch and protein material modifies under different conditions of process. So here different condition means the conditions can be modified in such a way to meet the consumer's requirement. Like suppose a child requires a chocolatey sugary product, or an adult requires a spicy product or a protein rich product, or so on and so forth. So it's a multifaceted, like whichever consumer asks for whatever product, with a different combination of process parameters, you can provide an unique opportunity to, like this machine provides an unique opportunity to prepare a novel product as per the consumer requirement. Therefore, this technique is called as a multifaceted technique. It gelatinizes the starch, it degrades the protein, of course, it improves the protein digestibility. Also, it forms the complexes among the lipid, among the starch, lipid-starch complexes. And we have seen in gelatinization or retrogradation, if you have these stronger lipid-starch complexes, how does that affect on the gelation, or how does that affect on the digestibility? Also, it forms complexes among the starch protein, which leads to the changes in the microstructure. Also, the chemical characteristics of the final product changes, like density, expansion, digestion, removal of anti-nutritional factors, and so on and so forth, okay? As well as the macroscopic shape of the product is changed. Like it is, like see, rice grits are this, and you are putting rice grit, and then you are getting a very beautifully expanded snack of your desired size or shape or whatever you are wishing for, okay? So you can produce with this technique or method breakfast cereal, savory snacks, even crispy flatbreads like khakra and all, pre-cooked flours for especially infant and baby food production, or especially for the old people who cannot digest, or they do not have teeth, so because of the age old, so they cannot consume the solid food, so these, or digestion also they cannot digest, so pre-cooked flours or pre-cooked food can be given to such special consumers. Cereal based baby food and textural proteins, like you have seen lot of textural proteins are available in the market, for example for those soya chunks or soya wadis or soya grits, or a lot of other textured soya protein products are available. Okay, so what is the principle involved? So overall, this is the extrusion. In the extrusion there are two types, like I will explain soon. So one is a single screw and the other one is a twin screw. We will see that in. So this is a single screw, in which, but in that case of twin screw, you will have the two screw. Okay, so this is the screw, and you will see this is the barrel. This is the heating or cooling jacket. Raw material is fed through this, and then the raw material enters, and this screw rotates. Okay, this screw rotates, and here this is a mixing zone. If you see from here, it conveys the food, and when this screw rotates, the mixing of the material occurs, and then it passes through the cooking zone, where also gelatinization, because of the shearing action of this screw, denaturation of the protein, or the improved all other physical, chemical, and nutritional, and plastification of the ingredient takes place, and this is the area where there is a high pressure, or this is a high pressure zone. And when the material here after cooking is passed from the high pressure zone, and immediately here there is a reduction of the pressure, or there is also dye, okay, dye of the desired shape. And if at the end the flavor, color, or other spicing material could be added or later on, generally it is added later on. But in case it is added here, it is at this age. So when from the material moves from a high pressure zone and immediately here when it comes, immediately the pressure drops, the expansion takes place. This is the rotating knife which cuts. So this extrusion, you know, is a continuous, you know, long extruded thing can be obtained, and this can be, you know, cut into desired. So raw materials are fed into the extruder barrel, and the screw then convey the food. Either this is a single screw or a twin screw. Twin means two screws. Okay, so this screw convey the food, okay, inside the machine. Further down the barrel, smaller flights restrict the volume. See, these are the smaller flights, okay, that restrict the volume, and it increases the resistance to movement of the food, so that, you know, the mixing takes place homogeneously here. Okay, mixing has a very, very important role. Okay, so as a result, it fills the barrel and the spaces between the screw flights and becomes compressed. As it moves further along the barrel, the screw kneads the material, okay, and materials into a very, very semi-solid or a plasticized mass. And there are methods like hot extrusion and cold extrusion. Cold extrusion is usually used for the pasta. You have seen the pasta noodles, and hot extrusion is used for the ready to eat snacks, like you have kurkure or you have those rings, onion rings, and so on. So hot extrusion involves heating above the 100 degrees Celsius. Okay, so here the frictional heat and any additional heating causes the temperature to rise. So either water or steam could be used here as a source of heating medium. Further, the smaller flight section of the barrel increases the pressure and the shearing action. Okay, here there is a shearing action. So finally, what happens? The material is forced through one or more restricted openings. See, here the die shape is different. Here it is a little bit of star or some kind of stars only. So there are different shapes, like here there is a different shape, here there is a triangle, and three holes or four holes or only just two holes, one big hole, moon shape, half moon shape, peacock shape, fish shape, bear, and so many of such, you know, shapes could be obtained. And you see the final, these are the ring, and then this is like a worm type of, and then these are kind of onion rings, cheese ball, moon shape, and so on and so forth. Okay, so finally the material that is homogenized, micronized, and kneaded is forced through from the high pressure zone, and then it discharges. As the food emerges under, so as the food emerges under pressure from the die, it expands to the final shape and cools rapidly, flashing off the moisture as a steam. So a variety of shapes, rods, spheres, Donuts, tubes, strips, or shells can be formed based on the type of dye that can be used. Okay. So typical products include a wide variety of low density, expanded snack food, and ready to eat puffed cereals. So as I mentioned, these extruders are classified into two types according to operation. Like as I mentioned, hot and cold extruders. Some of the food products need cold temperature, which wherein we do not want the product entirely cooked. For example, pasta or noodles, which can be brought home and then they can be cooked, and then hot extruders, which will produce ready to eat expanded snacks. Okay. So, and also based on type of construction, like a single screw and the twin screw extruder. Okay. So if you look here, there are parameters and that will differentiate between the single screw and the twin screw. What is the transport mechanism in the single screw? Friction between metal and food material. Okay. So transport mechanism here in single screw is the friction. Whereas in the twin screw, because of the arrangement of the two screws, there is a transport mechanism which is called as a positive displacement. Okay. In this also there are types, like in which direction these two screws rotates, okay, bilateral or collateral. Then capital cost, because this is a single screw, its cost is really low, whereas the twin screw extruder has a twice cost. It's a very, very expensive one. Of course, there are advantages also. Like in single screw, you need like at least up to 10% moisture content you can work. But in twin screw, even at a very, very low moisture content of 8%, you can work. Like that is the starting material. Okay, starting material moisture content. Mechanical power dissipation. Here, large shear forces ranging from 550 to 6,000 kilopascal. Whereas in twin screws, small shear forces of 2,000 to 4,000. Here you might find a large temperature difference, whereas here there is a small temperature difference. So looking at again, this is a single screw extruder where the principle is same. Okay, the principle is same, but the twin screw extruder, you can play a lot. You can modify the system parameter or process parameter a lot. The product quality is better than the single screw extruder. Okay, so these are the type of die openings that are available, but here it's not the restricted one, but you can have many. And in case of this, you have a co and counter rotating screws. And so let's understand. See, the basic principle or that process that takes place either in single screw extruder or twin screw extruder is same. Both of them would have these like sections. Okay. So single screw extruder contains a single rotating screw. That is why its name is single screw extruder. In a metal barrel. So this is your barrel, metal barrel. This is a metal barrel in which you have a single rotating screw, usually having a helical or axial grooves. Okay, see, these are helical or axial grooves, depending upon, like, there are different types of machines also, as I said, applications. So depending on this helical or axial grooves on the inner surfaces, which are able to convey the material to the transition, okay, transition section, where the screw channel becomes shallower. This is okay, shallower, and the material becomes compact. So the application of this single screw extruder for processing rice flour is very simple. Not only rice flour, I'm giving example because rice has a lot of starch, and it is research that using rice flour, it's very easy to obtain this expanded snacks very easily. So if you look, this is the hopper in which you add your raw material in the form of grits or grits only, like coarser material. This is the barrel. This is your screw, and with the help of motor, and inside the barrel, this is a very important one. When we are going to each step, we will see. See, this is the heater. These are the heaters. Okay, so with the heater, the heating takes place. At the same time, there are cooling fans. See, from this section to this section is called as a solid conveying section. From this section to this section, there is a melting section, and the last portion is called as a metering or pumping section, from where through the die the material get extruded. Okay, extruded. Nowadays there are advanced machine which are coming with the temperature control unit, wherein you can control everything. Like you can control the die rotation, die temperature, feed rate. Everything can be like controlled here in using this control unit. Okay. So this single screw extruder principally relies on three steps. It is conveying, carrying the raw material, swelling, like cooking or gelling material. But now I will explain when we see effect of extrusion temperature on the gelatinization. So see, when does the swelling of the starch happens? When you have a starch granule and when you have water. Only in presence of water swelling takes place, because the starch granule will absorb water. And when you heat, okay, see, native starch is insoluble in cold water. It is only soluble in the hot water, okay, or at a high temperature. So it needs two things. One is temperature, and another is it needs water. But since in the extrusion, the moisture content does not range, like a very high moisture content is not there, so a lot of swelling does not occur. Therefore, it is called as a melting. So the crystalline structure of the starch melts. Okay, how that we will see later on. But there is a melting, okay, happens, swelling of the granule, melting, and then degradation or modification or loss of the original structure and then modified structure. So these first two steps, like conveying and swelling, are done in the temperature cooling zone, like low temperature. Here you cannot use a high temperature. Whereas the most important step, that is gelatinization of the starch granule, occurs in the third zone, that is melting zone. Okay. It needs more resistance time in the third zone with respect to the first two. Obviously, because in the gelatinization, there are a lot of changes are happening, like molecules, physical property or pasting. Most important, the pasting properties of starch or pasting properties of the granule is entirely modifying. So therefore, there is a lot of more residence time in the third zone with respect to the first cooling zone. Single screw extrusion processing is feasible for the production of pasta, instant non-fried noodle, many other low-cost products can be made. A lot of things can be made. Only you have to play with the process and system parameter. It has been used for different purposes, such as soya and sweet potato flour blends, increasing the density and viscosity of orange pulp. See, this is such a novel application. Production of instant, like you take the orange pulp and extrude, and then you make the powder, and then you are changing the density as well as entirely, thing. Production of instant meal from extruded amaranth flour has been made. It is also used to increase the viscosity of the dough at a high sucrose concentration, and so on and so forth. What is a twin screw? So you see the principle is same, only the difference here is the two screw. Two screw means twin screw extruders are complex and expensive, but at the same time they have a several advantage over single screw extruder. The ingredients are thoroughly mixed inside the barrel. Having two screw, see this is one screw, two screw, before entering into other zones of extruder. So this twin screw extruder can operate even at a very low feed moisture, that I said compared to single screw, here it works even at a low. Now you will ask why we should work at a low moisture, feed moisture content. So there are certain ingredients which will give a very good or different quality of product, or if you add more moisture, the shelf life, or there are many other factors. Okay, so having low feed moisture is a very, very advantageous factor. So this operates even at a very low feed moisture and provides with a very good flexibility of operation to control variables of time, temperature, screw speed, which it does not happen in the single screw extruder. So if you look, it is the same thing like before it passes. So in two screw twin screw extrusion, there are two screws spirally flighted behind the die head, which improves the steady flow with the high pressure. This machine, that is twin screw extruder TSE, provides flexibility of using industrial byproduct like, as I said, pomace and anything you can use. Eggshell, there was one study in which the eggshell powder was used. As a juicy eggshell, what is the use of eggshell? You just throw, but it is a rich source of calcium. Eggshell powder was used. Its effect was explored on the extruded property of rice in corrugating the twin screw extruder. The texture of the developed product was very, very good, and fine cells along with the thin cell wall were observed, as revealed by the product was observed under microscope, and then microstructure analysis of these snacks were evaluated, and they were very, very good. Okay, you can imagine, like this machine can convert any hard material into such a magical final product. Increased dough moisture in a study conducted using twin screw extruder resulted into increased yellowness, star gelatinization, expansion ratio, and decreased cooking time when pea starch was used to make noodles. So in the noodles, you know, when you use pea starch, or pea has again a protein content. So as such, with the conventional method, it is not possible. But with extrusion, if you extrude and then use that kind of material for making the noodle, it really helps to improve the properties in terms of color, gelatinization, and most importantly, the expansion. Some studies also revealed that there is a decrease in the B value. L value indicates the lightness or yellowness. B value indicates the blueness or greenness, and LAB. Okay, A value indicates the redness. So the in one of the studies, it revealed that decrease in the B value and increase in L value was observed in case of wheat flour and cornstarch with the addition of, see, brewer's spent grain. This is a byproduct, and a red cabbage were used to develop snacks using the twin screw extruder. And the quality of the product was really, really very good. So conventional extrusion, either it is a single screw or a twin screw extruder, they uses mechanical energy to produce the heat energy, mechanical energy through this screw. This type of extrusion converts water into steam making it a dual function. So water, see, water is also very less. The moisture content is restricted here. The moisture or the water act as a plasticizer. There are other also plasticizers that are being used, like citric acid or glycerol. And there are many other ingredients which are being studied, which can help in giving you a very good expansion or a plasticizing effect. So during this process, temperature climbs as high as 150 degrees Celsius. Also, there is a, we saw there are the heaters, okay, in the section there are heaters and there is a screw, okay. So there is a shearing action or a shearing force or a shear rate, high shear rate, and also the temperature is very high. This harsh environment within the extruder has a very, very significant effect on the nutrient level of the final product. The limitation of the conventional extrusion include loss of heat sensitive ingredients such as fortificants, flavoring, and wear and tear of the screw, uncontrolled. Of course, you know, one has to be very, very careful when we are using the extruder.